Hi there, I'm Drew Badger, the English Fluency Guide, and in this video, I'm going to share with you why you should be learning English backwards, and also why I did the same thing, and that's how I finally became fluent in Japanese. けど、まずは、ちょっとだけ日本語で喋りたいですね。多分見てる人は、ドリューは本当に喋れるかどうかわからないですね。だから、ちょっとだけ言いたかったです。けど、字幕はちょっと書くのは、もうめんどくさいからね。それもあまりやりたくないから、もうほとんど、英語で喋ります。So I can speak some Japanese. Excuse me. Still recovering. I'm basically getting better, but what I just said is I can speak Japanese. If you have any questions, we can talk about that. I'll explain more about in this video why I don't use Japanese in my videos and talk about that a little bit. But first, I'm becoming much better. I know a lot of people were concerned about me, but I'm basically 100%. I'm still feeling just a tad bit weak. Maybe you can hear it in my voice, but I'm recovering, getting much better. I did not have coronavirus. Hopefully, I don't get it in the future. But again, my prayers go out to anybody who does have that, and certainly for all the people who are at home right now, or they're stuck wherever they are and they can't move, or they can't work, or they can't go back. So I want to just share a bunch of great videos with you, and hopefully in this one, I'll make it clear why learning backwards is a much better idea than basically learning the traditional way. So briefly, what I said in Japanese is, I know a lot of people, maybe they want to hear my Japanese, or maybe they don't believe I can speak Japanese or not. But then I said, you know, I want to keep it short, and writing the little subtitles and that kind of stuff is basically a lot of trouble. So that's why I didn't want to talk too much, because a lot of people wouldn't understand me. I have many followers in Japan, but many more outside of Japan. And very briefly, the reason I don't have one of those typical channels where I am either a foreigner or, you know, a Japanese person that's using Japanese in order to teach English is because it makes a deal with the devil. I call this a deal with the devil. If you've never heard that expression before, this means to you're trying to get something you want, but you give up everything to get that. And in the case of language learning, whenever you're using translations to learn, you're going to use translations to speak. So all the Japanese people who learn with me are all learning in English. I do very little teaching outside, and when I do that, I'm always taking time to explain to people that they should be learning in English and not trying to just learn more information in Japanese. So the whole subject of this video is learning backwards. So basically what most people do, like if you're going to study a language, like you're learning English, you're going to start learning here. Just put the first step here is usually learning some kind of vocabulary and through translations. I talk about this again and again and again in videos because it's so important. And when you're trying to learn a language, this is the same mistake I made, because everybody teaches this way. Everybody learns this way. Very few people do what I'm explaining you should do in this video. But you start kind of learning some kind of vocabulary. We'll put a V up here for that. And then we're moving over. Maybe you're going to learn maybe some listening. So you're trying to do kind of some basic things at the beginning. But the vocabulary is usually a bit more formal, and it's usually not a good way to kind of learn the language. We're going to call this like formal vocabulary. You're going to do some reading here, writing over here as well. And then we're going to keep moving. Usually some kind of listening, and this is where we're going to get, if you even do this in a class, this is where you do some kind of speaking, but usually this is not going to be anything that you would want to be really doing in a class. Most people, obviously, they want to speak, but teachers are not going to take the time to teach or have any kind of speaking practice in a class of 20 students or 30 students, something like that, which is typical. And even if you are learning by yourself, most people are trying to do this. So they're usually beginning with something like this, trying to read and write, learn some kind of vocabulary. And these things aren't, it's not like 1 week, the next week or something like that, but these are kind of the stages that you move through when you're first trying to learn something. And obviously these things are all connected, because you have to hear something in order to write it down. But the more important idea here is you're beginning more with reading and writing rather than speaking. And you're also doing it more with the formal vocabulary rather than the more conversational vocabulary that you would get when you're in real conversations. Excuse me. Again, I'm still clearing my throat. I'm feeling much better, but that thing really knocked me out. That's a great phrasal verb, to knock someone out. K-N-O-C-K, to knock out. Knock out. So the sickness really knocked me out. So it made me a little bit weak. And I hate feeling weak. I want to be strong, especially for my learners out there. And I know a lot of people are in some real trouble, much more serious than I was with this coronavirus stuff going around. Anyway, so the general idea here is you're beginning with the basic things. You're learning some formal vocabulary, doing some listening, reading, writing. And then if you even get the chance, you're trying to do some speaking. But this creates a whole bunch of problems for people. And this is usually what people like you out there encounter in your reading or writing or listening or speaking. All of those things become more difficult for you. Usually reading and writing are pretty easy for many people, but even a lot of people mail me and they complain about having trouble reading or writing for different reasons. But anyway, this is the typical approach. But what I did after I discovered that this didn't work, maybe you know my story about where I am here now in Japan. So I live in Nagasaki, Japan, and I was at a park not far from where I'm recording this video right now. And while I was feeling really depressed because this way of learning did not work for me, I noticed the little children speaking in the park, and I said, wow, they're not doing any of these things that I'm doing, and they're certainly not doing it in this order. So little children don't begin learning a language with reading and writing. They don't begin learning a language with formal vocabulary. They start here with speaking, and they move backwards. Now, this is a very simple idea, but it's something that I developed and really noticed, and I'm certainly not the only one doing it, because many people are, you know, good speakers of second languages. But most of the time, when you meet someone who's fluent in a second language, it's because they stopped doing this and started doing this. So the formal vocabulary, kind of one of my troubles with learning Japanese is that I don't study enough kanji. And so that's the written language, or one of the three written languages in Japanese. And it would be really helpful for me if I did, but I have to weigh my time, and some things it's maybe a better use of my time to do something else rather than studying some kanji. But I still learn quite a bit. But the thing that was most important to me was being able to speak. And this should be most important to you too if you're watching my videos. So what you're really doing here is you're beginning with the spoken language, and that's two things. That's speaking itself, and that's also the casual conversational vocabulary that people are using in everyday conversations. So again, it's really two things and not the formal vocabulary that you're trying to learn coming from this way of learning a language. Now, I don't want to take too much time about this video. If you've seen some of my videos before, you know I like to look at the big picture. Of course, I spend lots of time going into the details of how you do things like this, like in programs like the Fluency Course, Fluent for Life, all these things that I offer. It's all about learning backwards and then how we go through the specific pieces of that. But I really like I really impress this upon you, really want you to understand how important it is that fluency comes from going back this way. So you practice with speaking. And just to give a few examples of how you do this, now that I have two little children, a one-year-old and a four-year-old, I should get them in a video sometime soon. Post a comment down below if you'd like to see my daughters in a video. They're pretty funny. But if you watch them, especially watching my older daughter, Aria, who's watching movies or TV shows or whatever, especially things that she watches again and again, she starts copying them really quickly. And while most adults, you watch the difference between an adult watching maybe some song on a TV show for kids, or you're watching a child watch that same TV show, it's amazing how different that approach is for the learning and the practicing with that. Now, my daughter Aria, she will be very happy, even in front of other people, to be singing along. She's very happy to sing along with something, even if she doesn't know the words. Now, this is really important, because you can see, again, this is the opposite the opposite. We're going backwards here of what people usually do. Now, an adult trying to learn any song, even in their native language, or even especially as a native learner or a kind of learner of a language, usually begin with reading the song's lyrics. You might hear the song once or twice, but you begin by reading the lyrics, trying to memorize them, and then maybe we're going to try to sing and get the melody and things like that over here. But the opposite is what children do. Now, obviously, they can't read and learn the vocabulary by reading something the same way an adult could, but they're doing the opposite. They're moving from kind of the big picture to what's the melody. And so my daughter will sing something. If she knows some words, she'll say something. She'll use those words. Or if she doesn't, she just kind of makes up her own words just to fit in those spaces. And so what she's doing with that is she's getting a really good sense for how the language works. Now, isn't that interesting? So she's singing a song and she's singing, da da da, this is a time to do, da, da, and she doesn't really get it perfect, but because she's taking those steps to do it, we're always impressed by how quickly she really gets good at singing certain songs. And the rest of us are trying to sing it because we're trying to get it perfect in our head first. Isn't that interesting? So what people typically do, this is just one example of this, but people are, again, they're learning a language one way that doesn't really work, but everybody does it. Remember, always do what's different. If people are doing all the same thing, do the opposite. That's the most sane, smart thing you should be doing, even if you don't know exactly what to do, do the opposite. So you don't begin by trying to read all the lyrics and understand it. Just get a feel for the song. And maybe you know some words and maybe you don't. But moving this way and moving backwards, it helps you build your confidence much more. So you're just speaking along in the same way that you could speak along with how I'm speaking right now. So even if you're, you know, if you like the way I speak or, you know, you can find someone else, it doesn't matter, but that's what's going to help you become a fluent speaker. I don't want to get too much into detail about this because I want you to just understand this very simple idea of doing the opposite, going backwards rather than doing the typical thing that everybody does. Does that make sense? So if you've been learning this way so far, it's not your fault. This is the same way everybody teaches, but now you are an adult and you can choose to learn a different way. This is what I did. I stopped learning that way and I started learning a different way. And all I did was just watch what little kids were doing. And this is exactly what little kids are doing. So if you have little children, you can look at them and see how they're learning your native language, the language you're teaching them, or if they're just learning a different language and how they would watch a TV show or something. But they're learning, again, in the opposite way of what most people do. Hopefully that makes sense. If it does, post a comment down below. Let me know if this is helpful for you and if you'd like me to go into more detail about this. But hopefully this makes sense. Well, that's the end of this video. I hope you have enjoyed it. Again, do leave a comment down below. Also, if you are not yet subscribed to the channel, do click on the subscribe link at the end of this video and click that little bell icon so you get motivated. I can't remember the word. I want to say motivated and notified, but notified, but also motivated to click on the videos and see them when I release them. I probably will be releasing more of them during this coronavirus stuff because I know people are home and can't go out and learn anything. But if you'd like to see this in action, how I actually take people through these different steps, because what I really do in my programs is get people to stop learning this way and start learning that way. And I show you how to do that step by step in programs like the Fluency Course, which you can learn more about by clicking on the link in the upper right of this video or on the link in the description below this video. Well, that's it. I look forward to seeing you in the next video. And if you'd like to continue learning right here on YouTube with the English Fluency Guide, please do these three simple things right now. 1. Click on this link to subscribe to my YouTube channel for over 500 free videos. 2. Click on this link to download my number one ebook guide to fast fluency free. And 3. Click here to watch the most popular video on English fluency here on YouTube.